The Great Kapok Tree, A Tale of the Amazon Rainforest by Lynn Cherry. You take a look at the picture of the world here. You'll see the equator runs right through the middle of the earth. And on the left-hand side of the picture, you'll see the Amazon rainforest, which is where this story takes place. In the Amazon rainforest, it is always hot. And in that heat, everything grows and grows and grows. The tops of the trees in the rainforest are called the canopy. The canopy is a sunny place that touches the sky. The animals that live there like lots of light. Colorful parrots fly from tree to tree. Monkeys leap from branch to branch. The bottom of the rainforest is called the understory. The animals that live in the understory like darkness. There, silent snakes curl around hanging vines. Graceful jaguars watch and wait. And in this steamy environment is the great kapok tree that shoots up through the forest and emerges above the canopy. This is the story of the community of animals that live in one such tree in the rainforest. Two men walked into the rainforest. Moments before, the forest had been alive with the sounds of squawking birds and howling monkeys. Now all was quiet as the creatures watched the two men and wondered why they had come. The larger man stopped and pointed to the great kapok tree, and then he left. The smaller man took the axe he carried and he struck the trunk of the tree. Whack, whack, whack. The sounds of the blows rang through the forest. The wood of the tree was very hard. Chop, chop, chop. The man wiped the sweat off that ran down his face and neck. Whack, chop, whack, chop. Soon the man grew tired. He sat down to rest at the foot of the great kapok tree. Before he knew it, the heat and the hum of the forest had lulled him to sleep. A boa constrictor lived in the kapok tree. He slithered down its trunk to where the man was sleeping. He looked at the gash that the axe had made in the tree. Then the huge snake slid very close to the man and hissed in his ear. Señor, this tree is a tree of miracles. It is my home where generations of my ancestors have lived. Do not chop it down. A bee buzzed in the sleeping man's ear. Señor, my hive is in this kapok tree, and I fly from tree to tree and flower to flower, collecting pollen. In this way, I pollinate the trees and the flowers throughout the rainforest. You see, all living things depend on one another. A troop of monkeys scampered down from the canopy of the kapok tree. They chattered to the sleeping man. Señor, we have seen the ways of man. You chop down one tree, then you come back for another and another. The roots of these great trees will wither and die, and there will be nothing left to hold the earth in place. When the heavy rains come, the soil will be washed away, and the forest will become a desert. A toucan, a macaw, and a cock of the rock flew down from the canopy. Señor, squawked the toucan, you must not cut down this tree. We have flown over the rainforest and seen what happens once you begin to chop down the trees. Many people settle on the land. They set fires to clear the underbrush, and soon the forest disappears. Where once there was life and beauty, only black and smoldering ruins remain. A bright and small tree frog crawled along the edge of a leaf. In a squeaky voice, he piped into the man's ear. Señor, a ruined rainforest means ruined lives, many ruined lives. You will leave many of us homeless if you chop down this great kapok tree. A jaguar had been sleeping along a branch in the middle of the tree. Because his spotted coat blended into the dappled light in the shadows of the understory, no one had noticed him. Now he leapt down and padded silently over to the sleeping man. He growled in his ear, Señor, the kapok tree is home to many birds and animals. If you cut it down, where will I find my dinner? Four tree porcupines swung down from branch to branch and whispered to the man, "Señor, do you know what we animals and humans need in order to live? Oxygen. And Señor, do you know what trees produce? Oxygen. If you cut down the forest, you will destroy that which gives us all life." Several anteaters climbed down the kapok tree with their young clinging to their backs. The striped anteater said to the sleeping man, "Señor, you are chopping down this tree with no thought for the future. And surely you know that what happens tomorrow depends upon what you do today. The big man tells you to chop down a beautiful tree. He does not think of his own children, who tomorrow must live in a world without trees." A three-toed sloth had begun climbing down from the canopy when the men first appeared, and only now did she reach the ground. Plodding ever so slowly over to the sleeping man, she spoke in her deep and lazy voice, "Señor, how much is beauty worth? Can you live without it? If you destroy the beauty of the rainforest, on what would you feast your eyes?" A child from the Yanomamo tribe who lived in the rainforest knelt over the sleeping man, and he murmured in his ear, "Señor, when you awake, please look upon us with new eyes." The man awoke with a start. Before him stood the rainforest child, and all around him staring were the creatures who had descended upon the great kapok tree. What wondrous and rare animals they were. The man looked about and saw the sun streaming through the canopy. Spots of bright light glowed like jewels amidst the dark green forest. Strange and beautiful plants seemed to dangle in the air, suspended from the great kapok tree. The man smelled the fragrant perfume of their flowers. He felt the steamy mist rising from the forest floor. But he heard no sound, for the creatures were strangely silent. The man stood and picked up his axe. He swung back his arm as though to strike the tree, and suddenly he stopped. He turned and looked at the animals and at the child. He hesitated, and then he dropped the axe and he walked out of the rainforest.